Welcome to the video news of the week. In the March-April issue of Yankee Magazine, the North Country is well represented. The theme of the issue is The Power of Place, with stories featuring the northern part of the state. Last summer, editor of Yankee Magazine Mel Allen visited the Poor Farm homestead in Stewartstown. The story talks about the legacy of J.C. Kenneth Poor, who lived on the Stewartstown farm for almost the entirety of his 98-year life, and features many recent photographs taken at the homestead. The issue also deals with the opposition to the Northern Pass project. In a story titled, My Roots Are Deeper Than Your Pockets, area landowners speak about their refusal to sell out to the controversial transmission line project. The cover photo features a stunning image of the historic Wallace Farm on Route 3 in Columbia. The March-April issue is due to hit newsstands next week.
Saturday, February 16th was the 25th annual Umbagog Snowmobile Association Poker Run in Errol. There were seven stops along the 33-mile trip, beginning at the USA Garage Clubhouse and ending at the Log Haven. Funds raised went towards the upkeep of the trails.
On the piers, yeah. I got two.
Eric Queens.
These photographs were taken this past week on Hill Road in Pittsburg, showcasing some local wildlife that had gathered in a field and a vivid sunset that streaked across the sky as the cold North Country day drew to a close.
As the varsity basketball season moves towards playoffs, area schools recognized their outgoing seniors during games this past week. The Colebrook Mohawks were honored at the start of their game against the Yellow Jackets on Wednesday, while the Yellow Jackets had their ceremony during their game against Gorham. The Groveton Eagles recognized their seniors over two nights.
The Cape Breton family group, the Barra MacNeils, came to the Lancaster Rialto Theatre earlier this week as part of a New England tour. The five brothers and one sister were joined by a bassist for a dynamic performance on the stage of the Main Street Lancaster Theatre. The concert was co-sponsored by the Great Northwoods Committee for the Arts in conjunction with the Sky Theatre in Maine. We spoke with Stuart and Lucy MacNeil about their tour.
This is our first time out in the new year doing dates in Maine, New Hampshire, and it's really nice to get into a lot of these communities because although we've traveled through a lot of this area in the past, we don't make a lot of regular stops, so it's a real treat for us to get out here during the wintertime.
As we mature and time goes on, I think it's the core of the music is what really sets us apart from everybody else, and it's that, you know, the traditional Irish, Scottish music, the Gaelic songs, the family harmonies.
That was all around us, music, our mother's family, fiddlers and singers, and she taught us to step dance. And as we continued in the little concerts in home at Cape Breton and, you know, playing on these little stages and at homes, having these little settings where you can get to play a little tune and someone, it gives you that inspiration to want to play.
Last year celebrated 25 years with the Barra MacNeils since we released our first album, and two special projects came out of that. One was a live project with Symphony Nova Scotia. That album came out early last year, and toward in the fall we released an album that's called the Celtic Color Sessions. Every day we recorded with a different artist. Most of the artists were visiting the festival, but some of them were also people who live in Cape Breton. And so over 10 days, we
recorded with 10 different artists, and then we did a show at the end of the week that featured six of the artists, and the album is now available, and also for people who are interested in the Barra MacNeils, you check us out at barramacneils.com and also on Facebook for those who are on Facebook, and it'll keep you up to date and just let you know what we're up to.
His resting was a treasure, his own his weight hide, and when the leather bottle passed back by his side, he wore no shirt on his back with woolen to his skin, singing, how are you, and how are you, and how are you,
Colebrook Chronicle Video News of the Week is sponsored by the Upper Connecticut Valley Hospital in Colebrook. Visit their website at ucvh.org. Compassionate healthcare close to home. LaPerle's IGA of Colebrook. Great deals and instant coupons can be found on their website at laperlesiga.com. Colebrook Plumbing and Heating in Colebrook. Why heat with oil when you can heat economically with wood? Come see our whole house wood boiler solutions currently on sale. Murphy's Steakhouse at Bear Tree in Pittsburgh. Enjoy casual fine dining, a cozy atmosphere, and wonderful food. Try the chef's table on Sunday evenings. And by Woodsville Guaranty Savings Bank. Friendly local people, friendly local bank. And open 7 days a week inside Lancaster Shaw's. Steadily rising temperatures mark the weather forecast for this weekend. Friday will be mostly sunny with a high of 33. Saturday and Sunday bring a chance of rain showers, with Saturday's high reaching 37 and a low of 29, and on Sunday a high of 38 with a low of 27 degrees. In sports this week, the Pittsburgh Cane and Yellow Jackets played against Gorham in the Cane and School Gymnasium. Last Wednesday, the Yellow Jackets boys traveled to Colebrook to face off against the Mohawks. Watching the Video News of the Week.